Hey everybody. So one of the things that I'm talking a lot with patients about, with students, with, you know, on social media, is this concept around regenerative injection therapy and finding the pain generator and how we can look back at different procedures in order to try to evaluate if we actually hit the correct areas and if we can predict that a patient's going to have a positive outcome based on that. So to take a step back here for a second, one of the reasons that I believe that we are not doing well in a whole medical approach to chronic pain is because we are not doing a good job at identifying what the pain generators are and then applying an effective treatment for them. And when I say we, I'm referring to we as in the collective medical community, which is going to include every profession that has their hands in the chronic pain pot. And so with that, you know, it's one of the things that I've really tried to focus on in my own practice, but also in teaching students and other docs, is how can we find these pain generators so that we can effectively treat them? Because the reality is this: if your pain is coming from your supraspinatus tendon, but the only thing that's done for your shoulder is an intra-articular injection, whether it is cortisone, whether it is saline, whether it is 5% dextrose, PRP, adipose, stem cells, doesn't matter what it is. If the injectate does not get in the at least vicinity of the actual issue and where your brain is perceiving these pain signals from, then we miss the mark and we end up with a failure. We end up with a case where the patient is still in pain, or it's only a mild reduction in pain because, you know, maybe they had a, you know, 10% of their pain coming from intra-articular, but the tendon was the big, big thing that was causing the issue, and it was never addressed with the injections. And so that's something that I'm always trying to drill home. And so one of the interesting things is that during a procedure, one of the best things that can happen is recreation of a patient's pain. And so, for example, I'll use a different joint. So for example, if a patient is having pain that radiates from the hip down the leg, if that pain is actually coming from the insertion of glute med and glute minimus on the greater trochanter of the hip, if I hit that with the needle in the right place where their brain is perceiving those pain signals, most of the time it will actually recreate their symptoms and they will feel that pain radiating down into their leg. And so during procedures, I'm always talking with patients asking, is this pain familiar? Is this pain familiar? Because that's actually a way for me intraoperatively to figure out, am I in the right area? Do I need to expand my treatment options? So for example, if I didn't think that I needed to treat glute minimus, but I'm treating glute medius and I'm not getting the response that I want, and it could have been glute minimus, then I can switch over and I can treat glute minimus, and then, you know, hopefully I get the response that I'm looking for. And so that is something that we want and is actually, you know, really beneficial to get during these procedures, because it helps to reinforce that we're actually in the right area. And so I'm always talking with patients about this, because a lot of patients want to be told that this is going to be a painless procedure, or, oh, it doesn't hurt if it's the right person injecting you. Whereas my approach is such that I actually want to recreate some of your pain the same way I want to recreate some of your pain during a physical exam, because that helps me to figure out what's going on. But I want to recreate some of your pain during a procedure, because that confirms that we're in the right location, and that adds confidence to the fact that we're going to get a positive response. And I'll tell you, I've only ever had one case where I did a stem cell procedure on a patient, and during the whole procedure, I could not recreate his pain. And now, during that procedure, I ended up treating additional areas because I couldn't find his pain. And thankfully, the patient actually still had about an 85% improvement within 3 months. And that's actually extended out now to about 8 months. And so it's not that it's absolutely required, but I walked away from that procedure initially thinking, I didn't get the right spot, and I don't know if this patient is going to have a response, a positive response. And so thankfully he did, but that's only happened to me one time. Every other time I have made sure to go through and find the pain generator, because it adds to that confidence of being able to tell a patient, yeah, I think we got the right spots, and I truly think you're gonna have a really great outcome. And so what you guys can take from this, if you're not a patient of mine, if you're never gonna be a patient of mine, but you have had a procedure or you're going to have a procedure in the future, is the following. If you have a procedure and your pain generators are not recreated in a physical exam and more so in the actual injections, and you don't have a positive response, what it likely means is that the person who did the injection didn't actually treat the areas that are contributing to or causing your pain. And so it's not that prolotherapy doesn't work, or it's not that, oh, PRP doesn't work. It's not that. It's more so that the physician unfortunately didn't do a good enough job of treating your pain generator, of figuring out what that is, because that's the tough part, figuring out what your pain generator is and then going ahead and treating it with needles or however they're going to treat it in order to get a positive response. So I hope that kind of gives everybody a little bit of ammunition and some knowledge on what to go in with when you're talking with your provider and just trying to figure out how to get out of pain. All right, see you later, everybody. We'll be right back.